another day. This motor here is for the Integra, over next door. And where do I start with this? Let me just tell you first off, okay? So they used Honda Bond here, right? Maybe not even Honda Bond, but they used RTV. With the oil pan, they used nothing but, now stay with me, nothing but silicone all the way around. Even on the pickup, the oil pickup, because there's no windage tray in here, no oil pickup gasket, and no oil pan gasket. So I put the correct oil pan gasket, no silicone, because you don't need any with the one with the metal in it, the Perma-Dry one. We obviously, this has silicone in it. This has silicone on it. This has silicone on it. What else has silicone? This had all silicone. All this had silicone. Like, the VTEC gasket does it for you, but you don't need silicone. Like, they used black RTV here. They used a shitload of silicone here. They used these 10s that aren't even correct. It's missing one here. So, yeah, and look at timing. There and there. I haven't even cranked it over to see if timing is correct. Let's see. Nope. Not even correct. So I'm going to check timing, make sure this timing is correct too, because I got to take off the valve cover in order to put the cam seal gasket in. I got to clean this all out. You only put a little bit of silicone around it. Some people don't even put silicone and it still doesn't leak. I'm not that lucky. So they put silicone here. Mind you, he paid for this motor to get built. Okay. So what they did was they painted the head like this grayish color, but left the block alone. I mean, supposedly it's a fully built engine, but I mean, given the way that they treated it, I don't think it's fully built. Maybe the head is, who knows? Maybe the block, maybe, I don't know. The block looks like it has stock pistons. Definitely has stock rods, but I'm surprised they didn't use silicone on this thing. What else did they use silicone? Why is there silicone on this hose? What the hell? Oh no, look, no silicone here. Silicone on this, because they probably had a leak. What is this? Why is this hose like so warped? It's like, oh my god. They really did a number on this thing. And the owner wants to paint the block too, so that's what we're gonna do also. But man, this thing is just not taken care of. Oy. Looking on this furthermore, I see that they put silicone here and they put silicone there. So that means that they probably put silicone in here. God damn it. So you want this clean. You do not want any silicone on this, right? Because you suck that up, you're gonna have a bad time, right? Now, you know, I know what you're thinking. Usually things that suck up are pretty good, right? Wrong. Not when it comes to your engine. If things suck up into your engine, it's bad. But you know, if you get a girl down on baseline and she suck up, good. But we got this all squared away. You can see that there's some still residual here that I'm still trying to get, because you did not want any silicone on this thing or any dirt, due to the fact that when it seals, you don't want it to be impacted by the silicone. So you don't want like a gap, you don't want it to sit like this or sideways or anything, you want it flat. So anything that looks like silicone, just give it a light scratch. You can get these at AutoZone right here, these are great. So just give it a light little scratch. Don't gouge it. You don't need to scratch it in there like this. There's no reason to do that. It'll just come right off. So like, see, watch me. See how it's coming off this valve, the intake manifold comes off easy. So you don't need to scratch it all hard. No silicone, silicone bad. All right, now how do you install a thermostat? This is the only gasket you need, okay? So you gotta wrap that around the edge of the thermostat. But what I'm gonna show you is, it has these two holes here, right? They line up with these two holes here. There's a gold piece that sits here that lines up with this piece right here. So what you do is, you do it like this, right? Let me get a better view. Boom, that's it. You see how it sits flush? That's how you want it. So with the thermostat in, this gold piece is gonna be right there on that piece right there. And the thermostat housing has that same marking that'll line up right there to it. You see that? Boom. So that's how you pretty much do a thermostat gasket, in case if anybody wanted to know how to do one or is too scared to do one. That's how you do them on Hondas. They're super simple. This is how I tighten up things. Increments after increment, so that way everything sits flush and easy, nice and squeezy, lemon peasy. And then I tighten it like that. There it is, your thermostat housing is now done. Changing that is easy. Just change it out, put it back in, and your 10 goes here. All done. No more crusty ass, silicone ass thermostat housing. Pretty sure we can use that for something, but have to clean it out. These probably have silicone all inside of them. So we'll find out. Yeah, there's silicone on these bolts. Great. So you just take a little bit of silicone. I know it looks a lot. I'm not going to put that on there because it's not mine. That's all you do. Just a little bit of silicone. Not that much. Not that crazy.
No, just tell it it's going to hurt just a little.
And then you put it right in there. You take the cap back.
Don't tell your father. Just
jump stuff in there. And there you go. That's how you do it. And then you just put the two 10s back, and then you put the whole rail back on, and you torque them to spec, which we're finna do. So,
yeah, torque them to spec.
That's how you does it. Whoever built this motor didn't do a good job. So,
obviously.
Right? So what we had to do was we had to take off everything, get the timing back to where it was, and push these cam seals back in, because these camshaft seals were pushed out. Yeah. So as soon as you would start the car, it would start leaking oil. So we pushed them back in, and we placed them back in, put everything back together. It's not bolted, obviously, because I still have more to do, but for right now, this is it. And then tomorrow I got more work to do, because he's still using a crap ton of GSR parts. So I gotta, what?
Want a water?
Sure. So I still got more to do. Still waiting for the, get Bill one.
No. Water rusts your pipes.
So I still got to wait for the throttle body gasket, because this was throttle body gasket and silicone, which is not a good mixture, and it will fuck up your car. So, not really fuck it up, but it's not how I do things. It's not how we do things. Some people do things the right way, the wrong way, and the way that I do it. And the way that I do it is always correct. So we fixed the cam seals. And the guy said the reason why they're sticking out is because they're Type R cams. Yeah, I know. All right, it's the next day. Well, not technically speaking, because yesterday it was raining. By the way, look at how beautiful the truck is. Don't mind the leaves. Look at how beautiful that is. Alex is over here. He's putting in his new, well, rebuilt transmission. There was a problem with, what was it? Final drive. Final drive had a problem, and it's not his doing. It's not no one's doing. It's just, it was old, so they put in a new one, and it goes in. Everything goes in perfectly smooth. So I'm gonna show you what's going on with this engine. So I'm gonna need a VTEC solenoid gasket. They literally siliconed all these plugs in for some reason. They even siliconed this, which has threadings into it, which I don't understand. He's trying to get the speed sensor up. I need a throttle body gasket because the last throttle body that you guys saw was all covered in silicone. But he's getting the speed sensor off so that way he can put it on his car, and then he's gonna take it for a test spin to see if it still makes this whining sound that it was that I never put in a video. But, oh, and I need a VTEC pressure switch, which I don't have currently. So yeah, it's a lot of stuff going on today. And I got the Bubba's here. She's being super stretchy. She's always with me. I got the headers on. I need to find some more bolts that I have. Then I got to put the valve cover gasket back on. And as you guys saw, that I did this, and timing looks all right, but it is what it is. You know, he's putting on the speed sensor. We re-cleared the intake itself and painted this black, and kept that the original color, degreased it and everything, because you can degrease these. You can spray K&N spray on those, but I mean, we're gonna run that shit dry, because why not? And also, we re-cleared the hood. You can't tell because of the rain. There's a lot of tree sap on this thing. About to start it up. Ouch. Kick the shit out of that. Another day. Yeah. Another valve cover. Joe's over here with his Del Sol. What are you getting done to your Del Sol?
Oh, I'm putting a Type 4 head. It's already there, but you guys missed the whole fucking process.
Oh.
No, but we're just changing seals and gaskets and shit.
Seals and gaskets. So while he's doing this, I'm going to strip the valve cover and paint it wrinkle black for him and degrease it and what have you. Man, look at this thing. It's gross. All right, time to get the paint stripper from Mexico, from mi compa, right here. The only paint stripper I know that bubbles as soon as you put it on. That's how you know it's good shit. Look at this. Okay, it's bubbling. Like I said, dude, go to Mexico, get yourself a friend that goes to Mexico, and get yourself some of this stuff. Because that little bitch Greta Thunderbird or whatever her name is ruined everything, so now all the paint stripper here is ass. So shout out to my homie. I'm not gonna say any names because he knows who he is, and I'm not trying to get him in trouble. Because I don't know if this stuff is illegal. And look at how it comes out, watch. If it wants to come out. I can feel it. Come on. There it is. It's like a booger. And that's all she wrote. Now I gotta sand these down, sand that down, let it mellow, let it swallow, you know what I'm heard? You know what I'm saying? Know what I mean? They already got done with everything, but I had to clean it up and all that stuff, so that's why it took forever, but they changed literally all the gaskets on this right now. There it is. Come on, focus, focus. There we go. Yeah. Now it's time for the valve cover gasket, and then that's it. That's all she wrote. And then we're gonna close this video out. I'm hooking Joe up with a little Christmas gift.
stuff? Like, you kind of have to make it fit?
Yeah, and then you have to kind of, like, tuck it.
Oh, it doesn't fit. Damn.
Cover?
Yeah. Damn. I was going to give you this.
What does it fit?
You need the fatter ones.
Is that like a D-series or something?
No, this is B-series, but I don't know what that one's for. That's probably for an older B-series.
It is an OBD-1.
Hey, GSR. Did your mom got changed for 100?
I think so, yeah. You'd rather have to get one for a GSR.
Did your mom got changed for 100?
This is B-16. Fuck. Sorry. I was going to get you this for Christmas. Hey, but what's that for?
Does your mom have changed for 100?
Christmas.
Hey, you still got some of that black meat?
All right, Papa.
Yeah.
All right, for sure. But Shelly's on her way
right now. I'm probably going to do that intake. Just, I don't really care.
Michelle's on her way.
Just not red. That shit's ugly.
Okay, yeah, we can do it black.
All right. No problem.
Looks 100 times better. Three million times better.
What is it for? All the little harness it?
I just got to clean up this mess now. You want to pressure wash it?
Yep.
Can't pressure wash the valve cover though.
No, just like all the mess, the rest of it. And this shit and that part, that's it.
Hell yeah, that black on black is better than that ugly ass red.
So that's going to wrap it up for this video. If you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure you slap that like button. Please make sure you guys subscribe and stay tuned for more videos. I decided I'm going to try to upload at least once a week. So every Monday, 7 a.m., video drops. Remember, subscribe. My name is Chris from Lazymangarage, and I'm lazy, so you don't have to be. Peace.